Way back in 2005, we saw the creation of Preempt RT, a Linux kernel patch set. And finally, nearly 20 years later, this is being merged into the 6.12 Linux kernel. What does this provide, you might ask? This provides the Linux kernel with real-time OS functionality. Don't worry, we'll get into that in just a bit. Just because this is now upstreamed doesn't mean it wasn't in use before. You've probably used some out-of-tree modules. If you're an NVIDIA user, you're always using them. But there are things like how Canonical provides a version of Ubuntu with a real-time version of the kernel. There is Monte Vista, which provides a commercial Linux distro called CGX, providing this patch set. And certain distros like Arch Linux might have a package in the repos. And of course, being the Linux kernel, being open source, you could always just go and apply the patch set yourself and make use of this functionality. You didn't need to use it from a vendor who was providing it for you. Now, there is still value in having the functionality in the upstream kernel. It means it is something officially supported by the kernel. It's officially going to be worked on by the kernel. Being merged into the kernel, this means that it should be working in every single version going forward, because that's what you'd expect from something merged into the kernel. It also means it's much easier to approach this functionality now, because you don't need to go and patch the kernel yourself or find a version of the kernel that has the functionality in it. It's now just going to be in the upstream kernel. Now, I'm sure that some of you have a job working on a Linux server doing something else Linux related, and in those cases, you might use the patch set. But when we're talking about the regular old desktop Linux users, this is the most important thing. This patch set means absolutely nothing to you. It has nothing to do with pretty much anything you're going to touch. It has nothing to do with regular old video streaming from YouTube. It has nothing to do with game performance. It has nothing to do with keeping things synced in a rhythm game. All of these are things I've seen people discussing online, and it has nothing to do with that. So you're probably asking, what does it mean for Linux to have this functionality? What does it mean to be a real-time operating system? What is this going to let people do? Now, when we're talking about the needs of a general computer user, or even just a typical web server, whilst these have very different use cases, they do share one very important thing. It doesn't really matter how long something takes to process. It doesn't really matter if things happen in a weird order. If a process stays on the CPU for 20 milliseconds instead of 10 milliseconds, or a process is given priority over another one, yeah, it might cause like a minor stutter. Yeah, there might be like a slight delay in user access, but ultimately, it doesn't really matter. Like, you get over it a couple of seconds later and just go about your day. But this is not everywhere a computer is being used. What about in an industry that has actual real-world time constraints with actual real-world consequences if they are not met? Where if something goes wrong, it could cost a lot of money. It could cause actual damage, or potentially somebody might die. Let's say you have some medical equipment where operations must occur within a certain time frame. Let's say a defibrillator or a CPAP machine, where things need to happen at a certain interval. And especially with the defibrillator, things can go really, really badly if things are not happening exactly when they should be happening. Let's say you have a factory production line where items are heading down a conveyor belt and some robotic arm must interface with the item at the exact time the item is placed under where it needs to be interacted with. And if that doesn't happen, you might damage the item, you might damage other parts on the line, you might damage people around the line, you might shut down the entire line if something is done at the wrong time. Now, I do fairly low-end audio production. I record with a nice microphone. Yes, people use this microphone in a high-end context, but this is pretty ghetto what I do, but let's say we're dealing with high-end audio capture. You're doing audio production for some big celebrity. It costs a lot of money for them to be there. It costs a lot of money to mix that audio. You need to make sure the audio is captured perfectly in sync. You need to make sure there are no weird audio glitches, and everything just needs to work like it should. Let's say you have an automotive computer. Now, with the car entertainment system, it doesn't really matter if something goes wrong, but you know what does matter? The brakes, or the airbags. Let's say the user touches the brakes. Those brakes need to activate within a very specific time frame, or I don't know, you might die. The same with the airbags. The instant a crash happens, those airbags need to deploy within a time frame. You don't care if there's some other processing on the system. The brakes and the airbags, those take priority over everything. Now, these are things with very physical consequences. Let's say you have something like the stock market. There's a lot of money riding on making sure that everything is happening and everything is synced up and everything is, you know, going by the books. All of these are use cases for a real-time operating system, and this is by no means an exhaustive list. Now, the numbers obviously are going to be like kind of based on speculation and reports and things like that, but by next year, it's estimated around 30% of the world's data needs will require some level of real-time processing. Now, would anybody be surprised that the Arch Linux Wiki has documentation on the real-time kernel patch set? Real-time applications have operational deadlines between some triggering event and the application response to that event. To meet these operational deadlines, programmers use real-time operating systems, RTOS, on which the maximum response time can be calculated or measured reliably for the given application and environment. The highest priority task wanting the CPU always gets the CPU within a fixed amount of time after the event waking the task has taken place. On such an RTOS, the latency of a task only depends on the task running at equal or higher priorities. Tasks running at lower priorities may be ignored. Now, like most things in CompSci, there is some debate over the specific terminology being used. Whether this actually makes the Linux kernel into a real-time operating system like those specialized for the task like QNX and FreeRTOS, or if it's better to classify it as a general purpose operating system with real-time capabilities. I will not be settling that debate. I will leave that up to the people who want to argue about semantics. Now, to at least like rub our hands on the top of the weeds, this turns the Linux kernel into a preemptible kernel. That's what the preempt part of preempt RT means, whereby a task running can be interrupted with the intention of resuming it at a later point. Going back to that automotive example, the brakes, the airbags, they run now. It doesn't matter what's happening at the moment. I don't care. It does not matter what else you're doing. No one cares about your air conditioning. The brakes, the airbags, they're gonna run, whether you like it or not. Now, shortly after this whole thing started way back in 2006, Linus Torvalds said something about the project. Controlling a laser with Linux is crazy. But everyone in this room is crazy in his own way. So if you want to use Linux to control an industrial welding laser, I have no problem with you using preempt RT. But for the past nearly 20 years, it hadn't been upstreamed. And whilst there have been people doing exactly that, there is a lot of embedded systems already making use of this patch set. There was a lot of effort to get this resolved, right? Like, anytime you're introducing like a whole core new functionality to a kernel, there's gonna be bike shedding, there's gonna be arguments, and honestly, I don't think I can cover all of the arguments that went on because it's 20 years. 20 years of arguments. But they did get resolved, and the issue done. The patch set, whilst not going to be in a kernel that most of you have for quite a while, unless you're using a rolling release distro, it is going to be present probably by the time I would imagine Ubuntu 25.04 rolls around. But again, it's not something that you're probably ever going to use. Now, if you work in an industry where it is being used, awesome. Let me know what it is being used for. But as a desktop Linux user, this patch set being merged, this patch set not being merged, doesn't affect you. The way you're using Linux yesterday and the way you're using Linux today, it's exactly the same. You didn't have a kernel that had preempt RT. Now that you do, it is what it is. But it is really cool to know that Linux is powering a lot of things in the world we live in. So let me know your thoughts down below. Have you ever used anything that actually involves a real-time operating system? Not just, you know, used it at like a business, but actually like worked on it and you know how it all fits together. I would love to know. And if you have any questions about what a real-time OS might be used for, also leave them down below as well. So if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, subscribe to LibraPay linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and go and sub to the channel in real time.